Mga kaibigan, nagbabalik po ating radio show. Kagawad Mario de los Reyes ng Pakdal Barangay kasama si Mr. G on your radio. Binabati natin good morning Russell Balmusena and ang aking batchmate Russell, Sir Balmusena and Conchita Cariaga, Vijay Katakutan, Prox Tato. So ang dami nakikinig po. Guzman, George Jenson, Bentec. Ang pagkakalam ko po marami naging estudyante niyo po rito ngayon. Alden Tabaday Manangbao, good morning. Road Capuyan, Ariel Galidan Dangatan, maraming salamat sa pakikinig. Ang ating mga kaibigan sa Irisa, nakikinig po sila ngayon malapit sa site Press, maraming salamat sa pagpaparamdam. At sir, yung katanungan kanina, gusto pong malaman ating mga tagapakinig po ang inyong programa, ang inyong plano para sa Baguio. Unahin po natin tungkol sa education para sa mga pangkalahatan, hindi lang po para sa kabataan.
Being an educator, my primary concern, if ever I will be in the city council, would be about education. Take note, as I've said a while ago, Baguio is the best educational center in the north outside Metro Manila. It is saddening that sometimes, one time I was watching news in one of the TV stations, what was flashed was students in Baguio having rumble at Session Road.
Ah, yes, sir.
I think we need to address this so that it will not deteriorate. And we will maintain the prestige of Baguio as the best educational center in the north. We need ordinances and policies like perhaps coming from in the mind. Perhaps we need ordinances like total curfew for students during school days. Can you imagine parents sending their children to Baguio expecting that these students would be focusing on their studies, but then they are involved in fraternities or gangs. So we need some measures and perhaps I would take a study being usually when we take measures we need to have some study to really come up with better solutions to problems.
Sir, sa larangan po ng kalusugan sa health, anong programa po na meron po kayo?
Regarding health, you know, there are so many already ordinances and policies about health. It is just a matter of implementation. In the city of Baguio, so we have so many ordinances such that these ordinances are just there in the archives.
Yes, sir.
So, even the Department of Health, that all those policies regarding, let's say, for example, vaccination, but if they are really implemented, then they would suffice. So, perhaps implementation of policies that are already existing.
So sir, what we need now is strict implementation.
Yeah.
Ayan. Okay sir, pagdating po sa turismo po.
Sa tourism, perhaps for Baguio, being a tourist destination, yan ang primordial status ng Baguio, a tourist destination. Well, we maintain those good policies about tourism, but I would suggest na perhaps for every barangay there is a tourist attraction. Like for example, one time we went to Santo Tomas proper. That would be a good tourist destination for strawberry. For example, in La Trinidad, the tourist flock La Trinidad because of the strawberries. Here in Baguio, we have. So, perhaps for every barangay, there should be a tourist attraction. Like, for example, in Bayan Park, they have there a park. In Pakdal, we have adjoining already tourist destinations there. But the improvement of tourist destination for every barangay.
Galing po, sir. Sir, para po sa mga kabataan na nakikinig po ngayon, anong programang meron po kayo para sa kanila?
For the youth, because this would be side by side with education, they should be given more activities that would enhance their skills and talents. We already have sports, but you know, the sports activities that we have for the youth sometimes would not suffice.
Yes, sir.
Perhaps varied activities for the youth. Not only basketball, kung minsan nakakasawa na yung puro basketball.
Yes, sir. Sir, anong sports bang gusto nyo idagdag po, sir?
So, we will a provision wherein varied sports activities that would enhance the skills of depending on the choice. So perhaps an offering of various sports activities.
Mga kaibigan, natin mong special guest kagawad Mario de los Reyes ng Pagdal Barangay. Sir, programa po ninyo para sa environment na po ngayon.
With regards to environment, again, a stricter implementation of existing ordinances and laws. And then perhaps we should not focus on the primitive aspect of implementing these policies and ordinances. Perhaps we should introduce the positive side instead of simply giving them penalties, a sort of a reward for complying with the environmental rules and policies.
Sir, nakikinig po sa inyo, Mary Lou Ugatis, Anu Leia Sim, Darren Lester, Harriet De Vera, Jeros Mascarinas Benigno, and kasama po na nakikinig si Madam, hello kay Madam Migliam. Ay, sir, eto ang katanungan galing sa ating listener. Pakitanong po sa ating kagawad Mario de los Reyes ng Pagdal Barangay, anong kanyang programa para sa problema regarding garbage collection sa Baguio City?
Okay. Again, this would go side by side with environmental policies because proper garbage disposal would help maintain good environment. At present, we have this garbage collection problem. And then the hauling of this garbage to Ordaneta or Capas. And we are spending so much for this garbage collection and hauling of garbage. There should be a really serious effort to look for a engineered sanitary landfill for our garbage problem. Although at present, the present administration, I heard from Mayor Dumogan that they already have an intended engineered sanitary landfill. So perhaps we should really be serious. There should be a serious effort in looking for a place, a location for an engineered sanitary landfill for our garbage problem.
Sir, Nicanor Takudog sa Lupe, nakikinig po. Zandro Umangay Iko, Francis Degay, also listening to us right now. Maraming salamat sa pakikinig sa I Love Baguio. Sir, pagdating naman po sa peace and order, yan, para sa Baguio, ano pong inyong programa para sa ating mga kababayan dito sa Baguio City?
Again, for the peace and order, we have so many ordinances, policies that are just there. They are good for the papers. Paper tiger. For example, we have that silent night ordinance. But you will notice that is not being implemented. You try to go around.
Yes, sir.
That ordinance says that 10 o'clock, no more activities. Or no more, like for example, stores selling liquor. But then, this policy or this ordinance is not being implemented. For peace and order, I would still say that strict implementation of ordinances, rules and regulations that are already existing. So, political will.
Yes, political will. Napakaraming batas po, sir. Ordinansa, no? Pero implementation, hanging talaga. Ito naman po, sir, para po sa ating mga senior citizens po sa Baguio.
Senior citizens and persons with disability together. Because sometimes when you are already a senior citizen, comes with disabilities. So, together for this, perhaps we could introduce policies like giving more benefits to senior citizens, just like, for example, when an individual reaches 100, that would be the time they would be giving the 100,000. But in, for example, in Makati, at 65, they will already be giving a certain amount. Why not in Baguio? Although I heard that already from a certain councillor. But perhaps, if ever, we could look at this policy to be implemented, to be introduced also in the city of Baguio.
And sir, nakikinig po sa atin ang BCU, Baguio Central University, kaya Dr. Pieces Joe, Sir Joseph Unas, maraming maraming salamat sa pakikinig. Sir, pakibati po ang BCU po, sir.
Hi, good morning, BCU, Baguio Central University.
Ayan, ang dami po nila, sir. Kung po natin yung kapartner po natin, sir. Ang dami magagaling po sa BCU. Sobrang dami. Sir, pagdating po sa transport groups, anong inyong programa po, sir?
Again, for the transport group or for the problem on traffic?
Ayan, mas maganda po yan. Problema sa traffic po, sir, may nakikita po ba kayong pwedeng recommendation or solution in a way?
Again, for the problem on traffic, there was that idea of putting up a staging station in the south of Baguio and as well as north of Baguio. And I heard that, I heard that from an official. Like, for example, the dairy farm on the southern part of Baguio would be, they will construct a staging area there for all buses coming from the south. And then those passengers would already come from the staging area. They would utilize public transport from the staging area. So it would also give more job for the taxi drivers and public utility jeeps, because it will no longer be buses going to the Baguio Central Business District, but public utility vehicles. So it would, to some extent, ease traffic. But again, I would say that the problem on transport and traffic would again redound to stricter implementation of already existing rules, laws, regulations, and ordinances. Like, for example, this would also clean up government relative to transport. You know, I don't know why there are so many individuals who can register their vehicle even without parking space. But then there's a corruption happening somewhere. How come a person can register his vehicle without parking space? That's why at night, the roads are utilized for parking spaces for these private vehicles. So if I were to be in position, perhaps I would look at the stricter implementation of this, that you cannot register your vehicle without a parking space. Coming from, I don't know, I just picked this from some, they would say that they would just pay a certain amount to some fixers in the LTO or LTFRB, and they can already register their vehicles. So we have to look at this angle.
Yes, sir. Kagawad Mario de los Reyes ng Pakdal Barangay Maria Immaculata Chania. Yan, nakikinig po ngayon. Osborne, Visaya, maraming salamat po. Yan, sir. Ang daming nasagot ninyo po niyo, sir. Ang daming questions ang galing sa ating mga listeners. Sir, busy po kayo. How are you able to manage your time?
Managing my time, actually, I would say that I am full-time for public service because my family, all my family members, my wife, my two children are involved in service. My wife is employed, connected with the Department of Agrarian Reform.
Yes, sir.
In the Benguet Provincial Office. And my two sons are with the Armed Forces of the Philippines, particularly in the Philippine Air Force. They are PMA graduates. Then, incidentally, they also joined the same branch, Philippine Air Force. The other one is with the in Clark Air Base with the rescue, and the other one is with a new unit in the Philippine Air Force because of the modernization of the Air Force. There are so many units. There is that unit. I don't exactly remember or recall the unit, but this time the Philippine Air Force have already drones. So
yes, sir. It's high tech.
I think according to my son, he is piloting a plane acquired from Japan, and they would go all around the Philippines.
Wow.
I don't know
so
what unit was that. So, tinitingnan nila yung Benham Rice, yung sa Palawan, parang binabantayan.
Magaling, sir. Monitoring po rin sila ngayon.
Parang minumonitor. I don't exactly remember the new unit because that is a new unit in the Philippine Air Force.
Ah, yes, sir. Sir, si Madam Jocelyn Sublino is listening to us right now. Ating special guest, Kagawad Mario de los Reyes ng Pakdal Barangay. Sir, before we end our show, ano pong mensahe nyo para sa ating mga kaibigan, kababayan dito sa Baguio City?
My final message to our listeners and to the Baguettes, the citizens of Baguio, is based on three. A call for responsible voting first for this forthcoming May 13 election, because the officials that we will choose would be the people who would be at the forefront in directing our city. The kind of service that we will receive depends on the capability and character of the person we choose to do the task. Thus, if we don't develop and progress, or if we don't get the service that we ought to receive, we cannot blame those that have been voted, but rather we should blame ourselves. Because in the first place, we were the ones who placed and positioned them by our votes, and that we have not exercised our sacred right to vote wisely and responsibly. And when choosing, we scrutinize the personality of those trying to become our leaders. First and foremost, we should, although this might be highfalutin, the officials that we should be choosing are God-fearing and are paragon of rectitude and morality. Yung magiging modelo dahil kung yung official na mamumuno sa atin ay hindi maayos ang kanyang buhay, hindi rin magiging maayos ang buhay natin, it follows. And as the saying goes, which is provided in our constitution, sovereignty resides in the people and all government authority emanates from them. So tayo rin lang ang gumagawa. Kung ang ibinoto nating opisyal ay hindi maayos na opisyal, hindi rin magiging maayos ang takbo ng buhay natin. So it comes from them, it comes from us. So the change that we would want for our country and our city should come first from us, especially by exercising our sacred right of suffrage or sacred right of choosing our leaders. Good morning and thank you very much for this opportunity with DWLY, the Christian Station, 97.5 Cool Radio. Thank you very much, sir.
Salamat po, sir. Gagawad Mario de los Reyes ng Pakdal Barangay. Nakikinig po ang dating councilor ng Baguio City, Councilor Rocky Balisong po ngayon. Yan. Dr. Lumonar Trajano, BCU, kasama po natin ngayon po, sir. Sir, ang ating susunod na guest po, kagawad din po ng Luwakan proper, kagawad Gitwa Pingi Carpio. I-flash ko lang po sa screen. Ayan. Ayan po, sir. Ang ating susunod na guest po ngayon. Sir, maraming maraming salamat. Magkikita pa po tayo ngayong darating na April. Ayan, sir. So, God bless po, sir. At ingat po kayo lagi. Mga kaibigan, isang malakas na palakpak para sa ating kagawad ng Luwaka ng Pakdal Barangay, kagawad Mario de los Reyes.